Hola, my name is Noos. Today I'm painting this portrait for my mother. I wanted to paint her this photo from the two of us from a long time ago because I'm really proud of her and thankful for everything that she's done. It wasn't easy raising my brother and I now know what it's like to raise children, so I really admire her for that. And because she always supports my art and shows her interest in it, I wanted to make her this portrait of the photo of the two of us. Leave a like if you enjoy speed paintings and let's get into the painting now. First, I'm transferring my sketch onto my watercolor paper. I'm using Artist Cold Pressed paper. And for my watercolors, I'm using Winsor & Newton Artist watercolors. As the first step of the portrait painting, I give the face a base layer, and while that's still wet, I grab a vibrant color and map out where the shadows will be. After that, I'm giving everything a base layer to divide everything in smaller elements. Because this picture was really old, it was a bit on the blurry side, so I struggled a lot with the eyes in the beginning because those were in shadow but also blurry. So I couldn't get them right, so I covered them with my hair a bit. And in the picture my mother had her hands around me, but those were so extremely blurry, I couldn't get them right, so I decided to leave them out. Sorry for the changing lighting in some parts of the video, by the way. I was sitting next to a window, so I think a lot of clouds went by. I hope it doesn't bother you. After the base layer, I'm giving everything a bit more color, more contrast, and looking where I want to place some abnormal colors. Like, my mother's hair has purple and a tint of blue in her hair, but it's brown. I like to mix in some weird colors to make it more interesting. I'm keeping the portrait as vibrant as possible in the beginning because you can always desaturate the color. In the picture, my mom didn't have a lot of shadows in her face, but my face did, so I had to make up some of the shadows in her face to balance that out. By first painting in the hair, I established the darkest value in the whole painting, which helps you see if the other values are too dark or too light, because you can compare now. This is the first ever painting that I'm completely copying from a photo and don't change dramatically much. I changed a couple of things, but not like adding a spaceship or something. So it was really interesting for me, and I really liked painting photo and my mom and I. I was really nervous to paint the jackets because I'm not really experienced at painting clothes, so this was a real challenge for me, but I really like how it came out. I didn't expect that, so I'm really happy. My mom wore a denim jacket in the photo and a raincoat, I think. In the painting you can see that she wore a denim jacket, so I'm happy with that. And the raincoat Aine had on was a bit more difficult because it's yellow, and shading yellow is one of the difficult things for me, because the only shades I think you can a bit shade with are orange, brown, blue, or purple. Or red, of course. You could shade with all colors, but I desaturate them easily with yellow. So I try not to do that, but in the beginning I did it. So that was a bit hard to come back from, but I could scrub away some of the pigment, so that was fine. With closes, I really try to look at which wrinkles had sharp edges and which wrinkles you could blend out. At first I wanted to add a background because I want to fill up the page. But I asked my boyfriend for help, and we both agreed that the white, that it looked good as it was. And I really like how it looks clean and you don't know what my mother is looking at, just like the photo. So I left it this way, which made the tape a bit unnecessary, but yeah. And I'm really happy that I discovered that the tape doesn't rip the Arches paper, so I can just peel the tape off without a hairdryer. It looked always a bit weird in my videos, but now I don't have to anymore. After removing the tape, I saw that there still were some pencil marks from the sketch beneath the tape, so I tried to erase that, but it didn't go away, so I tried some white gouache and it made a little bit better. And I added some details on the painting because I saw some things that needed to be painted. I'm really a perfectionist, I want everything to be perfect, that's why I tried to erase my pencil marks. But I also think that pencil marks can add character and history to a painting, so I'm trying to let go of that more and not forcing everything to be perfect. For removing the watercolor sheet from the block, I'm using a plastic ruler because it doesn't damage the paper and it gets the job done. After everything was done, I took some pictures of the painting and gave it to my mom. My mom really liked the painting and said she's making a collage of everything that I've made for her. She was very happy with it and it was very special giving it to her. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you want to see more content like this. I upload weekly. And I wish you a very nice day. Bye!